வணக்கம் சார், வண்டிங்க உள்ளிருக்குள்ள குட் மார்னிங் சார். உங்க மைக் மட்டும் குட் மார்னிங் சார், மைக் மட்டும் சரி பண்ணி கேட்கும், கொஞ்சம் சவுண்ட் அதிகமா இருக்கிற மாதிரி இருக்கு. அதான் அதான் காத்தடிக்கிற மாதிரி இருக்கு, பாத்துக்கங்க. சரி, ஓகே ஓகே ஓகே. மேடம் குட் மார்னிங். Participants are coming, madam. So after that, we have to start the program.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Off. Off. Thank you.
அப்புறம் பேசுறமா மேடம், மேடம் ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணிடலாமா? மேடம் கங்கா மேடம்
சார். ஆமாங்க சார்.
ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணிடலாம் மேடம். ஓகே மேடம்.
ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணுங்களா?
ஓகே மேடம்.
A very good morning to you. all present here. I am Ganga Devi, Assistant Professor, PG and Research Department of Zoology, Arunmugu Panniyandavar College of Arts. First, I would like to show my gratitude to our management at Arunmugu, providing us encouragement and support to organizing this one-day international webinar on green synthesis of nanoparticles and its biological applications organized by PG and Research Department of Zoology, Arunmugu Panniyandavar College of Arts and Culture, Palani. Greener synthesis of nanoparticle can advance over other methods because it is simple and cost-effective and relatively reproducible and often results in more suitable methods. In this perception, I would call now Dr. C. Kandiben, Associate Professor, PG and Research Department of Zoology, Arunmugu Panniyandavar College of Arts and Culture, Palani, to welcome the participants and introduce to the today's speakers. Sir, now I handed over the session to you. Welcome you, sir.
Very pleasant good morning to one and all. On behalf of the college management, teaching, non-teaching, supporting staff and students of postgraduate and research department of zoology of Arunmugu Panniyandavar College of Arts and Culture, Palani, I take
in
a very pleasant good morning to one and all. On behalf of the college management, teaching, non-teaching, supporting staff and students of postgraduate and research department of zoology of Arunmugu Panniyandavar College of Arts and Culture, Palani, I take immense pleasure to extend a hearty welcome to one and all to this one-day international webinar on green synthesis-based nanoparticles and its biomedical application. Now, we are delighted to welcome our distinguished invited speaker, Dr. S. Vijay Kumar, Postdoctoral Research Fellow, Marine College, Shandong University, China. Dr. S. Vijay Kumar is a dynamic personality in the field of nanotechnology. Dr. S. Vijay Kumar is recipient of many awards and honors, to name the few: University First Rank Holder in MSc Zoology, Department of Science and Technology awarded the Innovation in Science Pursuit for Inspired Research Fellowship in the year New Delhi. He got an Outstanding Reviewer Award from various Elsevier journals. He is a top reviewers in pharmacology and toxicology in the year September 2019 from Bablans. Top reviewers in Crossfield in the year September 2019 from Bablans. He has visited many countries, Thailand and Indonesia, in connection with fellowship teaching assignments internationally. He has submitted many DNA sequences. He has published more than 47 research articles in peer-reviewed journals. His Google Scholar citation is 1,048. Also, his H index is 18 and the I-10 index is. He has attended many international and national conferences. He acted as a many reviewer in a. Now we welcome you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Now we are delighted and it's a great pleasure to welcome our respected beloved principal in charge of Arunmugu Panniyandavar, Dr. P. Prabhakar, who is always uncompromised in his commitment, devotion and dedication in his work. And we feel lucky to have such a hard-up personality to lead this institution and show the right path to us. We welcome you, sir. Special welcome to organizing committee members from Department of Zoology, most respected head of the departments, faculty members, students of various departments, our home institution and other institutions throughout India and abroad. Now I am glad indeed to welcome once again all the participants for this international webinar. We sincerely hope this one-day international webinar will greatly catalyze with interaction among research scientists, scholars, academicians, students and pave a way for scientific and healthy India. Thank you, one and all. மேடம் மேடம் மேடம்
நவ
ஐ ஓகே மேடம்
நவ ஐ கால் அபான் आवर கெஸ்ட் ஸ்பீக்கர் வெபினார் லெக்சர்
ஓகே ஷல் ஐ ஸ்டார்ட் நவ சார்
வெல்கம் சார்
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Good morning to everyone. First, I would like to thank to college principal and professor and head and organizing secretary and his team for the international webinar. And thank you for introducing to me.
சார் விஜய் விஜயகுமார் சார் பிரசன்டேஷன் இஸ் விசிபிள் நோ ப்ராப்ளம் யூ கேன் பிரசன்ட் யுவர்
ஓகே சார்
ப்ளீஸ் வெயிட் சார்
ஓகே சார் ஓகே ஓகே ஜஸ்ட் a minute Can you see my PPT?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. I want the PPT in full screen.
Yes, sir. We need full screen. Sir, full screen is view.
Yes, sir, but I can't my PPT full screen.
Sir, just you have to.
Okay. Can you see my PPT full screen?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes,
yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. I'm sorry for the interruption. Okay, I'm going to present my webinar topic: green synthesis based nanoparticle and its biomedical application. First of all, I would like to introduce my university. This is my friendship of. My Shandong University. My Shandong University working in various research field in the development of biomaterials developed from biomaterials in the marine sources and its biomedical application and tissue engineering applications. Today topic green synthesis based nanoparticles and its biomedical applications. If you want any participants want to competition, feel free to contact me these links and my email ID and contact number. Okay, I'm going to the topic nanotechnology. It is a nano is a Greek word. It means it is a dwarf. It is the 9 to 10 to the power of minus 9 range. It is the first introduced in the nanotechnology in 1959. Richard Feynman, they was first introduced in the concept of nanotechnology in the meeting of American Physical Society. He is entitled "There is plenty of room at the bottom" in 1970. Afterwards, in 1974, the term nanotechnology coined by Professor Mario Taniguchi in Tokyo University of Sciences. What is the nanotechnology? It is important in current scenario. It is a nanotechnology. It is very tiny. It is very small. It is compared to the bulk counter particles. It is a highly surface area. This is easy to the biological applications or versatile applications in various fields. Then approaches of nanoparticle synthesis. Nanoparticle synthesis is based into the two categories based upon the two methods of synthesis. One is top to bottom approach, another one is the bottom to top approach. The top to bottom approach, it is a macromolecule converted into the it's a fine particle. It is the method top to bottom approach. It is a submission in the method in etching, laser ablation, mining, grinding, sputtering. It is the method involved in the physical and chemical methods for nanoparticle synthesis. And another one, bottom-to-approach method is a very important method to the nano. It is a small particle converted into the nucleation, some of the mechanical molecules formation for the bottom-to-approach synthesis for nanoparticle. It is the division, substitution in the soluble process, laser pyrolysis, chemical reduction, stair pyrolysis, and wild process. It is the method used for the green synthesis of nanoparticles. You use everything for the capital in the biological process, example, plants, yeast, bacteria, and fungi. This method, you see the slide, in top-down process, in the bulk material converted to the fine particle in the top-down process, and bottom of the process, it is a degree method, I have already previous slide explained, if the atoms is converted to the newly formulated to the nanoparticle, it is the bottom of the process for the green nanoparticles synthesis. And for the methods, what is the types of nanoparticle? It is the nanoparticle classified into two categories, one is organic nanoparticle and another one inorganic nanoparticle. Organic nanoparticle include carbon nanoparticles and another one inorganic nanoparticles like metal and metal oxide nanoparticles. Example, metal, silver, gold, palladium, cadmium, copper like this and metal oxide, zinc oxide, titanium dioxide, silicon dioxide, titanium dioxide, it is the metal oxide nanoparticles. First of all, I am explaining some of the nanoparticles in inorganic nanoparticles, metallic nanoparticles, gold nanoparticle. It is a gold nanoparticle. It is a very important of the metallic nanoparticle. For the previous 2000 years, it is for nanoparticle used in nuclear cup. It is very important in the biomedical field. It is very biocompatible, high surface area, high electromagnetic, and used for the various regulatory applications for the gold nanoparticles. Another one, palladium. Palladium is one of the metallic nanoparticles. It is used for the various environmental applications for the catalytic reactions for the process. And another one, silver nanoparticles. Silver nanoparticles are very, very, very frequently used for the very known. Everyone knows the silver. It is a silver frequently used for the silver nanoparticles. It is a very highly antibacterial, antifungal properties, and it is a very catalytic properties, and also the very easily prepared for the nanoparticle in the silver. And another one, copper. Copper is one important. It is a highly catalytic property and highly antibacterial property. It is used for the some agricultural application for the nanoparticles applications. Another one, metal oxide. Metal oxide nanoparticle, it is one of the metal oxide, zinc oxide nanoparticle. Zinc oxide, it is GRAS. Generally recognized as safe, it is approved for United States Food and Drug Administration for the zinc oxide nanoparticle. It is a very low cost, easy transfer and transparent. It is a semiconductor material and high electrical conductivity property of zinc oxide nanoparticle. It is used for the day to like everything used for some cosmetics like some sunscreens for the ingredients of the zinc oxide. It is a very high antibacterial and antifungal property. Another one, titanium dioxide. Titanium dioxide nanoparticle also is a metal oxide. It is used to for some catalytic environmental application and also used to for some pharmacological properties are used for the some cosmetic products. Example, sunscreen lotion and some ointment paper for the in titanium dioxide. Example, it also used to some mix of product also the zinc oxide combination preparation of antifungal and antibacterial agent. Then, it is the important of the nanoparticle synthesis process. After the synthesis, the characterization is important factor. The characterization factor to determine the if it is nanoparticle or not. So, the physical-chemical characterization is a very important factor. The UV, first important one is the UV, another one XRD and FTER, ACM, TEM, EDR, theta potential, TGA, BD. It is a very, each and every characterization is an important factor of nanoparticle. UV, UV to identify the first initiate confirmation of synthesis nanoparticle and optical property to identify the nanoparticle in hydro spectroscopy. And another one, what is the crystalline nature of the sample nanoparticle analysis in the X-ray spectrometer? And the, what is the functional group present in the surface of nanoparticle to identify in potassium bromide method to determine the FTER, Fourier transform infrared to analyze the nanoparticle? And the size and shape morphological to identify the nanoparticle, SEM and TEM, scanning electron microscopy and transmission electron microscopy. And EDS analysis, purity and elemental composition to identify the nanoparticle and energy dissociative spectroscopy to identify the nanoparticle. And the surface charge and stability to identify the nanoparticle in zeta potential analysis, what is the charge present in the surface of nanoparticle. And what is the temperature, is the degradation or the decomposition property to identify the thermogravity magnetic analysis for the some nanoparticle, example metal oxide and metal nanoparticle. And DET is the very important of the nanoparticle characterization analysis, Brennert Kemmett Teller. It is identified to the nanoparticle, what is the surface area, how much surface area present in the nanoparticle to identify the DET analysis. And now the talk. What is the phytosynthesis? It is the green synthesis. Green, it is means plants. Used for the plants using the nanoparticle. Each current scenario is every researchers or scientists like the ECE and eco-friendly methods for the nanoparticle for the green synthesis. Then already the physical and chemical method already available. The physical and chemical method, it is various disadvantages. Like you have prepared the chemical synthesis nanoparticle. It is a highly toxic environmental pollution using for the toxic chemicals. Then physical methods, it is a highly space, highly requirement instruments we needed. So the alternative effect, eco-friendly and non-toxic and the easy preparation for the nanoparticle for the green synthesis used for the plants. And another one, it is a, you can ask the question, what is the, why we have developed for the nanoparticle in microbes? It is the microbes, it's a very, very maintaining property. It is a unique person, in very experienced person we needed for the microbes culture and maintenance. So the disadvantages like the microbial synthesis, it is a very better than the green synthesis, a better one. So these are the researchers developed for the green synthesis nanoparticles and obviously like for the green material like the plant and plant-based compound used for the nanoparticles. This slide, you see the plant sources for the metallic nanoparticle extract from different plant pods. Root and leaves and stems and fruits and peels and nuts and shells. It is used for the nanoparticle for the green synthesis. You see this slide. It is a very simplest and easy method. Metal ion solution mixed for like metal ion, like silver or gold or zinc acetate, whatever maybe you want. And you mix it with the plant extract and easily with the room temperature or heating some of the method for the synthesis for nanoparticles. And what is the green synthesis important? Important of, it is mainly important factor in the green synthesis based in nanoparticle. It is the present in the phytochemicals and phytocompounds or secondary metabolites present in the plant sources, examples like polylols, glycolides, alkaloids, carbohydrates, polyphenols, amino acids, some vitamin C, flavonoids, it is a phytochemicals. The phytochemical present in the plant capping, plant extract or plant capping agent present in the preparation of nanoparticle, it is a very important and advantage of the green synthesis of nanoparticles. This advantage is it is easily aqueous for water preparation and simple procedure, reducing and capping agent for protein and enzymes in polyphenols and alkaloids, flavonoids used like for the green synthesis nanoparticle, and high reducing potential and zero contamination and environmental friendly. It is the advantages of green synthesis nanoparticles. These are the some phytochemical secondary metabolites present in the some plant components, important components, like it is a chemical structure. This is a report in previously reported the silver nanoparticle preparation of the various green synthesis using the various plants, phytocompounds. Example, phyllanthin, hemophlorin, ruthenic acid, ellagic acid, U-fol, catechin, citric acid. These are the some of the phytochemicals and phytocomponents present in the plants. Example, like your garlic and allicin, and eugenol in the glove. It is a each and every plant has a different bioactive, each and particular specific bioactive compound. It is a preparation of nanoparticle in green synthesis. It's a very important of biopotential applications. It is a method, photosynthesis, a green synthesis of nanoparticle, preparation of plant extract nanoparticle synthesis, mixing of metallic solution in the bioreduction process, and the form the nanoparticle with further characterization and go to the biological applications, say, finally. Noble metal nanoparticle. In the noble metal nanoparticle, in the researchers in the various already previous slide I mentioned, in the leaf, root, latex, seed, in waste products, in the some peels utilized for the nanoparticle synthesis. Previously, a lot of researchers in synthesis, Osmium sanctum and aloe vera pardubensis and lemongrass for the nanoparticle synthesis in previously. And the therapeutic applications, what is the biomedical applications of the phyto nanoparticle? It's a lot of nanoparticle, it is a versatile application in the biomedical field in the some of the drug diseases and prevention and diagnosis for the biomedical application to the nanotechnology and the drug delivery applications. This is biomedical and the multifunctional applications in the imaging and therapeutics and synthesis of bioconjugation. Recently, some phytocompounds and also conjugated with the commercialization drug. Commercially available market in the drugs to develop the conjugated nanoparticle to the therapeutic application of biomedical field to the diagnosis and drug delivery. This slide, in nanoparticle products in the market current scenario, you see the slide, some of the images in silver nanoparticle sanitizer, water sanitizer, it's available in the available in the market in the Bangalore. It is a green silver nanoparticle, so it's an ointment cream band-aid. It is coated with the silver because it's a highly antibacterial agent to the coated with silver. And all around, water the sunscreen lotion in zinc oxide, titanium dioxide also with the sunscreen lotion, and water purifier also the zinc oxide and silver coated methods like washing machine, and also napkins for developing some antimicrobial coated nanoparticle coated napkins, and the cancer drugs also there. This is a product in Thailand for the nano particles or nano coated agent for the development of the market and available in the market in Thailand. In India also, the some of the paint also developed nanoparticle incorporated the paint in the walls because antibacterial in the some water resistant paints also used for the nanoparticle in paints. These are the products in the some of the branded, very good important branded also used for the market in the nanoparticle import in L'Oreal and the Homer Core and the Silver Nano Refrigerator. Some of the shirts also present in the nanoporters. Well, then go to the topic in the biomedical application in the nanoparticle. What is the biomedical application? Each and every nanoparticle is a different characters to the specific property. The lack of biomedical application. Each and I'm explaining the slide each and every one explain detailly. First one, antibacterial activity of nanoparticles. Today, current scenario, day by day increasing the bacteria microbes because each and every microbe, because nowadays it is resistant to the antibiotic because we have needed the alternative antibiotic therapy to the bacteria. To develop the, in current scenario, researchers developed the nanoparticle to the novel antibiotic therapy, antimicrobial therapy for the some bacterial infections. You see the slide in my research. I'm done my research in L'Oreal Nopalis. It is one of the bay leaves. It is a Tamil in biryani pattai, bay leaves. Used for the synthesis zinc oxide nanoparticle to tested the clinical pathogen, Pseudomonas aeruginosa and staphylococcus aureus. It is the human pathogen, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, a lung infection. It is a staphylococcus aureus, skin infection also developed. We have tested the zincoxin nanoparticle, laryngopolis exactrota zincoxin nanoparticle, to three different concentrations, T1, T2, T3 you mean. Increasing the concentration, increasing the zone of inhibition to tested the two pathogens. It is a very highly antibacterial present in the zincoxin nanoparticles. This paper published in 2016 in Biomedical Pharmacotherapy Elsevier Journal. You refer the paper directly in this link. Then next one, antibiofilm. What is the antibiofilm? The antibiofilm activity of nanoparticles is a very important one factor. The antibiofilm, it is the very main important factor. What's the biofilm? The biofilm, it is a group of microbes. It is a cluster formation of microbes. It is a tend to be more than 100 times fold. It is a single bacteria. It is a cluster-like formation of the bacteria. It's a group of bacteria. It is a control too difficult. It is the biofilm formation. It is the clinical healthcare settings in the hospital surgery, in the hospital environment, in some catheter devices, some urinary devices present in the biofilm bacteria. The biofilm bacteria mechanism, it is a very resistant to some of the antibiotics because the biofilm bacteria present in the EPS in the body. It is the protection layer of antibiotic therapy. So it is a very resistant to the antibiotics. It is the biofilm, it is like the cell to cell communication. It's a part of the Lux of genes. It is the biofilm formation to the eradication, to the alternative antibiofilm therapy, to the researchers developed in the nanoparticle in recent current scenario, to the lot of incorporated in the drugs and also the some of the plant components to incorporate to the various nanoparticles to the inhibit the biofilm formation. You see the slide. It is the methicillin resistant staphylococcus aureus and Pseudomonas aeruginosa. It is a clinical pathogen. It is developed for the biofilm. In my research, I am done the garlic. It's a garlic in garlic. Garlic extract coated silver nanoparticle prepared for the silver nanoparticle to be treated in different concentration. You see the A, it is a light microscope, inverted microscope image. It is a B, confocal. Confocal microscope, it is one of the important advantages microscope, confocal laser scanning microscope. It is a microscope used for the live and dead cell assay, in live cells assay, image analysis for the to visualize and test the samples. You see the slide, in the control, it is a very cluster formation like with the control in MRS and the light microscope and confocal microscope. And after the treatment slide, patient decreasing the biofilm ratio. And biofilm in GAGM case 100 microgram per ml, it is a reducing the biofilm ratio in the light microscope and the confocal microscope. You see the slide in the control is a cluster formation. You differentiate easily. It is a cluster concentration increasing and decreasing the biofilm thickness. It is the 2D images. It is a 3D. You see the image. You clearly visualize the
slide. Not visible slide.
Sir, hello.
Slide not visible.
Sir, visible, visible, visible. Hello. Sir, it is visible. Sir, it is visible. Sir, it is visible. It is visible, no problem at all. But they are not pin the screen. So your presentation is visible. Proceed, sir. Proceed, sir. Proceed.
Now okay?
Yeah, visible, sir. No problem. Okay? Okay, sir.
Okay, okay. Yes, okay, sir. This is the 3D microscope, confocal laser scanning microscope 3D analysis. You see the slide, MRS areas. It is a control. It is a very thickness in high concentration thickness in biofilm formation. After the treatment in the nanoparticle, decreasing the biofilm thickness to the two different bacteria in the highly concentration, decreasing the biofilm thickness and biofilm inhibitions. This paper published in the Photochemistry and Photobiology. You see the any reference or any refer the paper or point out the information about this work, you see the paper. And another one, anti-angiogenesis activity of nanoparticle. It is a very important factor of biomedical applications in the nanoparticle. What is anti-angiogenesis? The angiogenesis, it means in blood vessel formation in the existing growth of tissues formation in the cancer's development. It is the anti-angiogenesis effect in the nanoparticles to the inhibit the unwanted the new blood vessel formations. I am clearly explained in the next slide. You see the slide. It is the control. It is tested for the anti-angiogenesis effect. It is the CAM assay. CAM means chorionic allantoin membrane. It is used for the chick embryo in the chick egg to develop the nanoparticles. In the chick embryo, it is a control slide. It is a formation of the lot of blood vessels. You see the one of researchers developed the treated the anti-angiogenesis effect of nanoparticle in gold nanoparticle. They are developed the gold nanoparticle in the Mangiparas indica, mango seed extract based synthesis of gold nanoparticle to treated the anti-angiogenesis effect of nanoparticle. You see the slide in the in the gold nanoparticle treated, it is the treated the slide in the inhibition of the new the another blood vessels. You see the compare the slide in A and B. It is a very good anti-angiogenesis effect. It is the anti-angiogenesis effect of chick embryo in the chorionic allantoid membrane assay. They are reported Vimal Raj et al. And another one author 2018 reported. I am also working on the anti-angiogenesis effect in the using for the biopolymer gelatin. Then anti-extent, what is the anti-extent? It is, we have the body in the development of some diseases in the production of free radicals. They inhibited the unwanted free radicals to the anti-extent activity. Yeah, because the why the researcher in the green synthesis of biomedical in anti-extent property and the each and every plant compound or plant particular or fruits and plants have the different particular anti-extent compound present in the extract or vegetables or fruits, because they incorporated into the in metal, example like silver or coated or zinc oxide coated in the nanoparticle development to the anti-accident activity in the DPPH assay to production to the inhibited the unwanted free radical in reactive oxygen phases assay in compared to the commercial standard drug vitamin C to tested the anti-accident property. It is a mechanism of it is a anti-extent, is a free radical unstable molecule present an unpaired electron. It's a mechanism to the anti-extent some nanoparticle production to the metal oxide in the previous research to intensive to the some enzyme inhibitors and free radical inhibition of the anti-extent nanoparticles. Another one, anti-inflammatory. The anti-inflammatory of nanoparticle is one of the biomedical applications, a very important one. It is the inflammation. The inflammation, whatever it is, it's an accident, trauma, and swelling effect. It is the reducing the inflammations or activities to the nanoparticle in the activity of the standard the compared to the standard drug. Example, aciclofenac or diclofenac is commercially available in the market. The standard drug to the developer the nanoparticle to the green extract to compared to the commercialization market product standard drug and also the our nanoparticle to treated the anti-inflammatory activity of some enzyme activities to tested the example BSA assay, bovine serum albumin or human blood also through in the assay used for the anti-inflammatory activity of nanoparticles. It's a mechanism, it's an example harmful things enter the body injury or inflammation into the effect in the inflammations. Then another one, anti-diabetic activity of nanoparticle. Diabetic, each and every person would still have the 10 to the out of 10 to the 8 to 7% the diabetes, diabetes 1 or diabetes 2. It's a diabetes major day by day increasing. We have already commercially available in the some of the standard drugs we have put in the market, but it is a lot of side effects, the vomiting, some side effects, some unwanted diarrhea. So the rectify the problem to develop the alternative and some nanocoated to develop the nanoparticle in the anti-diabetic effects to tested the in vitro lab and in vivo in rat and mice model to tested the alpha amylase and alpha glucosidase and DPPV4 assay for the anti-diabetic activity of nanoparticles. It's a mechanism. There's a pancreas, the self-injected insulins, examples, the alpha glucosidase inhibitors. It is the nanoparticle. There's some enzyme increasing, decreasing the enzyme decreasing the some nanoparticle. Example, the metformin. It is the standard drug utilized for the diabetic. It is also incorporated to the some green extract to coated the nanoparticle development for in anti-diabetic therapy. Another one is anti-cancer activity. The anti-cancer, cancer, it is a very important factor one. They are very important in the current technology, drug development for the nanoparticle. A lot of various researchers, various research going on cancer field to develop the nano. In the nanoparticle, in the example one, like aptamer, dendrimer, and liposome. And based on a lot of researchers, like in the green synthesis, some plant or seaweed compounds to develop the incorporate a nanoparticle to treated the anti-cancer activity in vitro and in vivo level. Already available in the treatment of cancer treatment, surgery, radiotherapy and chemotherapy. It is a lot of side effects. It is killed to the unwanted, killed to the normal cells, because we have needed the alternative therapy for the cancer. So the nanoparticle development, the anti-cancer activities. You see the slide, it is one of my research paper. It is A549, human lung cancer cells. I'm developed the nanoparticle used for the use of paradisiaca banana fruit peel developed for the nanoparticle in the gold nanoparticle to treated the lung cancer cell. It's a higher concentration, 100 microgram per ml, reducing the cell viability and also the cell morphological changes. You see the slide, saline DMSO medium, it is a control. It is a treatment. It's a treatment of the slide. It is a cell. It's a slump, some like clumping and the formation of the shrinking of the cells. It is the anti-cancer activity of nanoparticle. This paper published in the 2017 Microbial Pathogen says, you see any reference of you on the paper, you see the paper. And another one, wound healing. It is a biomedical application, wound healing. A lot of research in wound healing. Wound healing, it is a very major process. It is a wound healing, it is a critical process in the after surgery or any accident or any other trauma. Because the wound management, it is a critical process. It is because a lot of invading the microbes or pathogen entry into the wound, it is a partition of biofilms also. Because we have needed the alternative wound dressing or wound ointments needed because the development for the nanoparticle incorporated the green methods to the development the anti-wound healing, wound healing agent. Because already commercial available in the market, silver already we have used for the some accident in the in burns for the silver sulfosamide used for the wound healing agent. It is ointments for the wounds. Nowadays the research is developed for the nanoparticle incorporated the gels and ointments to develop the wound healing. Example, in the chitosan, one of the biopolymer, it is the US FDA approved for the, it is a wound accelerating agent and wound healing agent. It is developed from the shrimp and crab cells for the chitosan. You see the slide, it is our in vitro wound healing activity of nanoparticle. It is one of the paper recently published in the Miracos Photodiagnosis journal. This you see the slide, it's a control, it is a curcumin. Curcumin, it is one of the very good antibacterial, antioxidant, anti-cancer agent. It is a curcumin coated, utilized for the in vitro wound healing activity. You see the slide, it's a wound scratch assay. They scratch the cells, 0 hours, not migration, any migration. After the 24-hour treatment, curcumin and curcumin incorporated the silicon nanoparticle to migrate the cells into the after another area, because it is a healing property of the wound. It is the one of the method into the researchers in used for the fibroblast cells, human fibroblast cells, with the wound healing activity in the in vitro levels. Another one, it is a wound healing activity of in vivo level in the some researcher using rat, mice, or rabbit used for the in vivo models in the wound healing activity. You see the slide. It's a A, B, C, D, F. F is the wound healing. A is the control. BC, it is a different control. It is for the some, this researcher used for the copper sulfate, for the copper sulfate ointments, incorporate the green synthesis, F vulgaris used for the capping agent into the nanoparticle. The after treating effects, a very good in vivo level killing effect of the mice. The B, F, in the below image is B, is a histology collagenase, this migrations effect of the copper nanoparticle to treat the activities of wound healings. Then another one application biomedical field is a vector control. What is a mosquito? It is a mosquito large scale application of nanoparticle. It's a lot of pupils and dead in the some insects by some parasitic. The mosquito is a very important control to the recently researchers research growing, because the mosquito is everyone resistant, because already commercial available in the market in the chemical chemicals. Chemicals, because it is the resistant. It's some DDT, dietrin, organophosphorus. It is commercially available in the market. The mosquitoes are very resistant. So alternatively, we have needed the alternative anti mosquitocidal agent. The in research is going on. Developed the green synthesis nanoparticles and some other compound, phytochemical compound, specifically compound isolate to the anti-mosquitocidal activity. You see the slide, it is one of my co-author paper reported in 2017. It is a Aedes aegypti larvae. Some of the plant used for the euphorbia and arothiana, so have incorporated to the silver nanoparticle. It is controlled with the silver nitrate. It is a plant-based silver nanoparticle to treat the mosquito. It is a highly activity in the reducing the mosquito and larvae and pupae formation, and we deposit into the nanoparticle to the mosquito gut. It is a highly anti-mosquitocidal agent. It's a paper published in Journal of Clusters in 2017. Then anti-parasitic, already mentioned some mosquito and tick worms, which tested a lot of researchers working in the nanoparticles. Another one, we have the our research group to develop it for the anti-parasitic, the human lice activity. If you see the slide example, it is my one of my friend paper, Rekha et al. 2019 reported crustin. It is one of the hemolymph protein for the animal source, developed for the titanium dioxide nanoparticle to treat the human lice. To treat it is control. It is after 50 micrograms. After the treatment, the human lice also the because the death and mortality rate is higher, and the inhibit and accumulate of the nanoparticle in the body of the human lice. Thank you. Hello.
Sir.
Hello.
Okay, sir. Any Hello. Questions? Questions, sir. Any other questions in the chat box? You can answer, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay, just a minute.
Hello.
Yes.
Sir, can we ask directly, sir?
Yes. Proceed. Hello. Proceed, ma'am.
Sir, I'm Dr. Anupama, RBVRR Women's College, Hyderabad. Sir, your lectures were yes. very exciting and very informative.
Thank you.
I have Thank some you. Doubts, sir. Can I ask,
yes,
sir?
Yes. Yes, it's my pleasure. Yes.
Layman can also understand about the nanotechnology. In that way, okay. you delivered your lecture.
That's good.
Okay.
Sir, actually my research is bio-inorganic chemistry, that complexes preparation and DNA binding studies, etc.
Okay.
Can we prepare nanoparticles from the metal complexes, sir?
Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm. Already previously lot of researcher on the metal complexes. But okay. I am not as a chemistry person, I am a basically zoology person. But in my knowledge, a lot of research in my friend also working in the metal clusters and metal complex. Example, zirconium, silicon, zinc oxide to the some metal complex working the environmental applications, catalytic properties, and some cancer studies also metal complex studies. Yes.
Can we do DNA and protein binding studies of those nanoparticles?
Yes, ma'am. You have selected the nanoparticle. It is human body biocompatibility. It is very important factor. Because
yes,
silver is a toxic. I think silver is a highly toxic, but zinc oxide is a very biocompatibility of our cells. Because it is one of the trace metal, zinc oxide. You choose zinc oxide is well better, I think. Zinc oxide or copper, like this.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much.
Hello, sir.
Can you share that collaborative research slide, sir? You want to?
In my slide? Hello.
Second slide, sir. Collaborative research details.
Okay, you can contact me in my number or my mail.
Sir, that slide, can you share, sir, once again?
Yes. No, I will tell you. You contact me my mail.
Thank you so much, sir.
Yes, okay, thank you.
Yeah, hello.
Yes.
I'm Jay Kumar from Government College, Mailur, Madurai. Okay. I got a specific question. All these things
yes,
can
sir.
Be, okay, silver nanoparticle preparation, applications, and verification of the property, all those things. But what about the
Hello. Sorry, sir, I can't hear you. Please repeat your question.
Yeah, all the things, nanoparticles can be prepared well and it can be tested in the lab conditions.
Yes, yes.
What is the practical application? How do you confirm your practical applications in field conditions as far as the mosquito larvae is concerned?
Yes, sir, because recently researchers developed in the nanospace. Some of the research developed the nano coils because some plant compounds incorporated the nanoparticle to develop the some coils. We have used the liquid agent, right? Good night or some other all-in-one some agents. Because the agents who developed the liquid to develop the directly incorporated the electricity to tested in researchers in the field work or the mosquito cidal agent.
Fine. My question is not that. It is because what your answer is, in a confined condition, like in a room, we can use the liquid silver nanoparticle based thing we can use. That is practically possible. What about in field conditions? Because in drainages, the larvae develop.
Yes. Because the researcher...
Is a spray or what kind of condition is prerequisite for the field, open field condition?
Yeah. That's open field, the research has developed for the filter in the some of the nano-coated filter papers to tested the field in the paper to tested the some sewage items and some other things like the mosquito laid in the X or not to confirm the field work.
Second question is about diabetes. How you confine yourself with the usage of nanoparticles in a diabetic patient where most of the molecules prepared are toxic in nature? Because if you can consume silver coated nanoparticles for a diabetic patient, already suffering, and this will add to the toxicity also. So how can reduce the toxicity of those substances?
Yes. First of all, the selected the nanoparticle in the one of the trace element, like researchers, a lot of researchers selected on the metal. Zinc oxide incorporated in the drug, conjugated the drug, like commercial drug, metformin, some other drug, to incorporated the nanoparticle developed in vitro level, after the in vivo level tested the mice and rabbit, and afterwards the human trials. It's trials going.
Okay.
In research.
Right, sir. Okay. Very good presentation. Thanks a lot.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Yes.
Could you a very nice presentation. Could you please elaborate on nanotechnology involved in the remediation, especially when it comes to microorganisms and enzymes?
Yes. Degradation.
Yeah, remediation or degradation with respect to microorganisms like your bacteria, fungi, the enzymes in collaboration with nanotechnology.
Yes. Yes, ma'am. In my friend also working on the in this bioremediation work, incorporated the nanoparticle like zinc or copper or silver, incorporated the some probiotic or plastic eating bacteria to incorporate the metal to treated the bioremediation work and environmental applications and also the remediation prospectus.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, sir. A very nice presentation. I have one question. Currently, like in agriculture, how we use this nanoparticle to control the diseases and pests which comes as per the seasons, like in mango trees? Or second question, how we use this thing in aquaculture also and a feed additive to control the diseases?
Yes, sir.
And other things.
Yes, sir. Already in my PhD research experience, I'm also working in the nanoparticle aquaculture because the plant-based or seaweed extract-based synthesis nanoparticle to treat the aquaculture animal in the immunomodulatory agent. In the nanoparticle example, zinc oxide, the trace element, it is mixed with the commercial feed, mixed with the diet control and immunomodulating agent and post-pathogen interaction studies also.
The fermentation type of a things in aquaculture feed or in the this is the second question. The first question in agriculture.
Yes, sir. Agriculture, some of the products in some copper, like the zinc or palladium also developed the nano sprays to develop kill the worms and insects, agricultural insects, and also there some researchers working on the nano sensor diagnostic disease and to the nanoparticle incorporation into the agricultural aspects.
Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Sir, very nice presentation. I have some questions. EGT useful in genetic improvement of field crops, field crop yield improvement of field crops.
Feedback from what you
can. Yes, sir. But incorporate to the nano material to the trace element, it is possible, I think. Yeah, agricultural prospect and a lot of research going in nanotechnological.
There is research findings or
predictions? No. I am not a research finding, but the researcher, some papers reported and developed into the sensor working and the nano sprays and the insect controls.
The yield improvement or quality improvement? Quality improvement or yield improvements.
Yes. Lot of research reports binding available. You see the Elsevier, because there's some researchers bindings the chitosan incorporate to the zinc nanoparticle to the some maize plant or some of the plants in the growth improvement and reduce the disease. It is also available, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Hello, sir. Sir, can you tell me the name of Marin? Can you tell me the name of marine plant source which is used for therapeutic agents or biomedical applications?
Yeah. In marine source, a lot of seaweed, example like green seaweed, red seaweed, also the sodium alginate, laminarin, fucoid, and also develop incorporated the nanoparticle to the biomedical application in anti-cancer, anti-biofilm, anti-bacterial agent, and aquaculture aspects, immunostimulant agent, also the aquatic animals.
Okay. Good morning, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Good morning, sir. Congratulations for your excellent presentation and your authentic research. I would like to ask one query is, can you light on the treatment of Alzheimer disease due to the nanoparticles?
Yes, ma'am. Already research is going, but I don't know the Alzheimer disease. I'm not working Alzheimer disease. But I have seen the paper, lot of papers in Alzheimer's disease. Yes, definitely.
Okay. So, in your sense that we can treat Alzheimer's with the help of nanotechnology?
Yes, ma'am. Sure.
Okay. And do it has an impact on other diseases? If suppose we are treating one particular disease, if during the treatment of that particular disease, can the another disease also be treated with the same nanoparticles?
Yes, ma'am. Yes. We have checked the compatibility and we have the efficiency of different disease, right? Yes, definitely.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, sir, for answering my question. Thank you. Have a wonderful day. Bye.
Thank you.
Hello.
Yes.
You are working very excellent with a good knowledge.
Thank you, sir.
Good experience.
Yes, sir.
So you have also worked on the nanoparticles to cure the lung diseases. Why can't you explore, to remove or maybe stop this corona, because there are number of drugs and vaccines they are trying,
but
they are the best particles where you can also work on this corona, because by inhalation directly it will go into the lungs and it will also blast the COVID-19.
Yes,
have you thought about it, because you have lot of experience with the number of nanoparticles and doped nanoparticles, bio nanoparticles.
Yes, sir.
What's your opinion?
But I don't have any idea about COVID, but some research in last week I read the paper, some nanoparticle quantum dots used for the corona testing, but by bioinformatics level the research identified as what is the protein involved, what is the molecule involved. After the confirmation, the quantum dots nanoparticle to the research. is going.
And doped with the maybe a gold, maybe suitable for this.
Yes. Yes, sir. Yes, it is a very biocompatibility agent, sir. Gold. It is a, but only disadvantage is like high cost. But it's a very drug delivery application. It is very useful, sir. In but gold.
I know infection of this disease worldwide pandemic. I think yes, people sir. Will not bother about the cost also.
Sir, yes, Nimal, sir, can I say on that? Because yes, last sir. Week I had attended one webinar. It was an international conference actually from University of Kalyani, West Bengal. And I have attended that particular conference. And in that conference, I have learned that some scientists are working on treatment of coronavirus due to with the help of this nanotechnology. They are preparing one mask. Which is right. actually prepared, which is prepared by the nanoparticles. So the research is going on actually.
Yes, and ma'am. Actually, this research is going already. Previously, yes, nano-perforated mask and gloves also developed. Yes, some nano sprays, nano sanitizer. This research is going on, sir. Yes. Definitely, maybe yes. in future, Sara Gilbert lab also developed for the some nanotechnological work in
negative COVID. Me. Silver as so well as
they are creating a nano mask which will absorb these particles and these particles will get degrade on that particular nitrocellulose membrane itself. So I had attended that session and it was a wonderful session and it was a wonderful knowledge they shared actually about nanotechnology.
A mask and all these are temporary, madam. They are not going to cure the disease. What we want presently in this entire world is whether we have to have a vaccine or
yes, maybe. They are working on the preparation of vaccines also, sir.
That is required.
They are preparing this for the vaccines also. University of London.
Yeah. Well, it is a great presentation, doctor. You have a lot of experience and you have shared your knowledge on this biomedical research.
Thank you.
I really appreciate.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Any other questions from participants? Dear participants, ask any questions. Sir,
solunga sir.
Sir, we have to finish the same webinar. Any questions in chat box? There is no question, I think.
So before that, I want to thank both of you. The presenter presented the session very well, which was much informative, great informations. Thanks for sharing that. And the organizer, Dr. Gandhiban sir, well organized. Maybe you can organize many more such events in the days to come. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Professor. Thank you, Professor. Ma'am, Ganga Devi, ma'am. Ma'am, Ganga madam, madam, Ganga madam, Ganga madam, deliver your word of thanks, ma'am.
Sir. Now it's time for showing our gratitude to the program, those who are helping for the program. First of all, I thank our management and our principal to giving an opportunity to arrange this webinar. Next, I would like to thank Dr. S. Vijayakumar, Postdoctoral Research Fellow, Marine College, San Diego University, China. Then his presentation is very informative and very enthusiastic and presentation. He explained what is nanoparticle and types of nanoparticle and phytochemicals, then phytosynthesis of nanoparticle, then application of nanoparticle in microbial application and other aspects. Then the question answer session also very interesting, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your elaborate presentation. Then I like to thank our department HOD, Dr. C. Condiban, PG and Research Department of Zoology, Arulmigu Palani and our College of Arts and Culture Palani, to arranging such wonderful webinar on this occasion. Thank you, sir. And I will thank our department colleagues and the participants, those who are make this webinar successful. I thanks one and all present here. Thank you. Sir?
Okay, madam. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thanks for all the participants. Thank you, sir. Dr. Vijayas Vijayakumar, sir. Thank you very much for your nice presentation.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
And it is very informative.
Thank you, sir.
Most of the participants are satisfied. They gave a lot of positive feedback, sir, about your presentation.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.